Hey, welcome to Multinet Design. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss or talk about Revit 2024, the new project, the new development of Revit and its implemented technology. But what we want to discuss most here is about how to convert your existing project to a template file, because a lot of people have issue that Revit template does not have a quantitative reason to which people are modeling things. So let me give you an instance of what I'm talking about. Now you create a new and you see imperial multidisciplinary, because that's the way it has been arranged now. So it's instead of having architecture, structure, MEP and so on and so forth. So they have already disciplined themselves into two categories. Now that there is no other ones, other one I see existing, but if you decide to click like this now, multidisciplinary, let me just use metric, because that is what I want to use because of meters and a few other things. So if you have a metrics, let me continue loading. So this one is particular. So you have a lot of activities going on here in this project browser at this site. So it's full of a lot of different kind of confusing browsings. So the point here is that they made it more reasonable if you are doing a large project. So it's more easy for you. But if you're an individual like myself that work basically on a what client wants, and I base my design based on architectural alone, I'm not doing multidisciplinary activities. So this one is okay for this one is not ID for me. So how do you get your own project browser? I mean project template file that you can be using. This is what we want to do. And someone has already complained that a lot of especially this crop view is not functioning, is not showing. The reason is not showing because they've already set this one particular to a modifying size that can never be reduced or increases. So that is why you don't rely too much on things like this. So what I'm going to do here is that how to use open your existing file, existing project, and use that to convert it to new project templates that you can be using and reuse and reuse every time. So, and a lot of you might be wondering, okay, the color is not changing or something like that. This is where you change the color. If you have it already, don't go to options. So you get this color interface and change this to the light mode. So every other things are like this are here in the Revit, except this one that has newly introduced. So check it to the change it to the last, and you check back to the dark mode. So this is the beauty of the new 2024. That is only thing, the positive plus that I saw that I've seen here that is not there before. So now let us open a new, let me just search for one of the, okay, I did this recently, LRG model. I'm going to use it to create a lot of tutorials, so I expect you to follow suit one after the other. So now you look at it from here, look at the 3D. So this is the 3D for this particular thing. So what we want to do here is that I want to use this complete template to create a new one. So how do you do it? If you use this one to create a template file, it's going to be too heavy. So what you need to do, as we have it here, is that you need to delete everything here. They are no more functioning, they are no more useful, since you want to convert it to templates. So how do you do that? First is that you go to your file and you say save this as a template, and it's going to take you to a particular place that you can save whatever you want to save it to. So what you need to check is the template file is this RUTE instead of RUVT that is a project used to come with, but this is a template file. So this one will save for you. So the moment you click here and you say, just click anywhere, maybe on your desktop or server you want to save it to. So I'm giving it like this and say, okay, my template file default, let me just call it my default template. So this one is going to be the template I'm going to use to create every project I want to create. So I'm going to say save It will definitely save. So after you have done that, never you go. You have not done. This one has already given you that to save as a template, but you are seeing it as a file. So instead of you to be seeing all this one every day, whenever you are opening it, just highlight them like that and delete. So anything that you have on the plan, you go there and delete everything that are not applicable to what you need them for. So delete everything individually. Do the same thing here. Delete them. You don't need them. You know, remember it's a project before, so that's why you have to delete everything that you have there. So you have a, so all, like all this one, you don't need them. You can just delete them. So there are no more functions. So leave the only these elevations, the 3D, the foundation, and so on and so forth. So you go to your sheet too. So the sheet that you have here, if it's okay by you, you leave it there. So you can look at it like that. So this is your sheet. If you, this one is what you need. If you don't need it again, you can create more one. So you can check most of the tutorial that we have done in the playlist, and you see a lot of things that we have done there. So that is this for that. So this one allows you now. So whatsoever you want to control in this place, you can control it. You can imagine these things like this. So these are the things you need to work on, and that is how it's being done. So after you have done this one and I've gotten it right, you need to save back again, save, and you see save as, click on save as again. This time around, you click on this save template and you say save. So it's going to ask you to override it. So this definitely has already overrid everything. So this is now the new template that you have. Now when you close here, when you say now you need to take that to where you're going to be seeing it, because now when you close here and say you want to open a new project, it's going to ask you a question. So what you need to click on browser. The browser is coming, giving, is bringing you to this particular place, because this is the default area. Why is it the default area? That's the place that means significant from the beginning. And let me show you where those places are there. So click on the options. At the options, you are going to see file location. So file location at the place that everything has been dedicated, like this now. The parts, so the family template, this is where the parts are. So when you click here, browse, you are going to see where it is. So you see this English Imperial, this is where it's been stated. So that is why this part has been there. And this one, multidisciplinary, and those are the parts in which all these things have found themselves. So you are not the one to change them. Only what you just need to do that, don't touch anything here, because it can be causing another issue for you. So the best thing for you to do is that you go and bring your home template file you have created and take it to this place. This is what we want to do now. So close this. As you have done that now, this is a template file default. So what you need to do is that you click here and say where you save that template file feature, go there, like click here. Where do I save it? On the desktop. I save it on the desktop. Click there and say desktop close. So here, this is the template file that I've created. So copy it here now and go back to this list and say new, and click on new file projects, then browse here. So it is here now. So you right click, because you have already copied, then say paste. So this is it, my default template. So this is the file you are going to use. So if you click here now, you open it, it's going to open for you and you say okay. So that is it. It will open and it will establish itself as a default file template. So if you close everything now, close all your projects, everything from beginning to the end. Close everything. Now, so if you want to start a new project afresh, after you have opened the Revit, then you click on new. So you click on browse and you see my default template already installed. So this one will allow you to continue working on the new projects you have. So that is what I just want to explain in this particular. So many other tutorials will come in after this. So try to subscribe to our channel.